So I just received an email from one of my viewers, and here's her story. My sister, who's in 3rd grade, had a math test, which was just normal multiplication. But then one of the questions on the test goes like this. Mr. Gomez had 87 stickers. He gave all of them to his class of 20 students. Some students received 4 stickers, and the others received 5 stickers. How many students received 5 stickers? And the email continues. I haven't practiced any high school level algebra or calculus since I'm a freshman undergrad in college with a non-STEM major, so I'm pretty washed with my math skills. But doesn't this problem require a system of equations? Which is high school level math, right? Is there any possible way that a third grader could have answered this question without using a system of equations or trial and error? Alright, let's have a look. 87 stickers for 20 students, some got 4 and the others got 5. How many got 5, right? Yes, totally. Usually you will just use a system of equations to solve that, which I'll demonstrate later. But for third grader, I think this is the best way. Yes, you still have to try and error. I think the amount of computation is okay though, in my opinion. But anyway, let's try. So some people got 4 stickers, but I don't know how many of them. So I'll draw a box right here. For example, right here, I can put, let's say, 8. That means 8 people got 4 stickers, and I'll just multiply, right? 4 times 8, I will get 32. That means I have used 32 stickers. But I don't know how many people right here, so not yet. But we will also have to account for some people got 5 stickers. So 5 times something. And then I will have to combine them, so I'll add them. Altogether, I must have a total of 87 stickers. So this is what we have to achieve, right? What to put here, what to put here. And also, this plus that has to be equal to 20. Okay, so let's go ahead and think about it. Firstly, we have 20 students, so let's just cut this into half, right? Let's try 10 and 10. 4 times 10 is 40, and then 5 times 10 is 50, and if you add them, you get 90. And in my opinion, this is a fair amount of computation, and then right now it's like, okay, you see, this is not the correct answer, because we're trying to get 87, not 90, right? So, not that. But 90 is not too far away from 87. That makes this question somewhat more reasonable, in my opinion. This is only 3 away from 87, right? So that means we should somehow reduce by 3. And this right here, check this out. The difference between 4 and 5 is 1. That means we should have 3 more people receiving 4 stickers, and then 3 less people receive 5 stickers. That will produce the 3 less in total. That's pretty much it. So let's see, 4 times something plus 5 times something, I need to end up with 87. I need to have 3 more people receive less stickers, so that would be 13. And then 3 less people here, so 7. Together, we do end up with 20 students, yeah? And you see, if you multiply this and that, we get 52. If you multiply this and that, 35. Add them up, we do end up with 87. So we have gotten our correct combination. And the answer to that will be 7 people, right? So the answer here is just equal to 7. So I think this is the best that I can come up with. Again, the numbers, they are not so bad, because if you reason it out, you really don't have to try a lot of combinations. So that will be my best solutions for a third grader. Why don't I show you the system of equations too? Here we go. Firstly, let's go ahead and define our variables. Let me say let x equal to the number of students. I'll just put on PPL for people. So number of people who got 4 stickers. And then I say y equals the number of people who got 5 stickers. From here, we must know that x plus y equals 20, because that's the total number of students that we are dealing with. So that's the first equation. And for the second equation, because we have x many people who got 4 stickers. So we have to do 4 times x. This will produce the number of stickers that they all have right here. And then we have to combine why many people got 5 stickers. So just 5y. Altogether, the amount of stickers is 87. And ladies and gentlemen, that's the system of equations. And because we're trying to see how many people got 5 stickers, meaning we're trying to solve for y. So from here, let's go ahead, minus 1 on both sides. So we get x right here equals 20 minus y. And then we can just enter this expression into this x here. Have a look. We will get 4 times 20 minus y plus 5y equals 87. And this equation will allow us to solve for y, and y is the answer. That's pretty much it. But then let's just go ahead and solve it. So this right here will be 80, right? 4 times 20 is 80, and then minus 4 times y, and then plus 5y equals 87. Combining this and that is y, and that's plus 80 equals 87. Lastly, minus 80 on both sides, cancel. We get y equals 87 minus 80 is 7, which of course is the same answer.